finally be standing in front of you as the new Florida Heavyweight Champion. I did it. And now, I don't care who it is. I will defend this title anytime, anywhere, any.
Congratulations! We're so proud to call you champion. In fact, I wanted to come out here on behalf of my conglomerate to let you know how proud we are. But I couldn't help but hear that you said you would put your championship on the line against anybody, right? It just so happens that I know someone who wants a shot. And his name is Black Pain.
You talk about big, angry men that can really hurt you.
And here we go. Whoa, buddy. And the massive, mastodonic Black Pain has just taken out Eric Escobar.
Greetings from the Sunshine State. This is the FCW Arena in beautiful downtown Tampa, Florida.
It's gonna be a tremendous night once again. Got a packed house here. They're running. They're just going crazy.
This is a tag team match scheduled for one fall. Coming to the ring first, accompanied by Byron Saxton, the team of Tyson Tarver and Lawrence Knight.
Well, with his conglomerate, Byron Saxton walks around FCW like he has an S on his chest. But he can act that way with the guys that he's got backing him.
Man, that's so true. He might have an S on his chest after a night because he's represented all over this program tonight right here. Channel 47, the Bright House Sports Network, and FCW Florida Champion Wrestling coming synonymously, if you will, in public. It's good stuff.
Introducing their opponent, the combined weight of 526 pounds, the team of Caleb O'Neill and Johnny Prime.
Let me lay an interesting fact on you right here. Johnny Prime, Caleb O'Neill came out a few weeks ago when Johnny was, wasn't seriously injured, but was feeling really, bad, had some bumps and bruises, and said, hey, get out of this kid's face. I like this kid. So I'm really anxious to see how these two kind of interact. You know, I'm talking about Caleb and Johnny Prime. Johnny Prime is one of our young rising stars, as you know, Josh.
Yeah, for weeks and weeks, Johnny Prime had been giving the conglomerate nightmares. But finally, the numbers game caught up to Prime. And it was a couple of weeks ago, as Dream just mentioned, that the conglomerate orchestrated an assault and injured Johnny Prime. And clearly, everyone here in the FCW arena glad that the MRI came back negative for Johnny Prime. He's back in action and ready to take on the conglomerate with his good friend, Caleb O'Neill.
Well, friendship aside, I don't know, like I said, I just really don't know how they're going to coexist. But, I talked to Caleb, and he sounds sincere. Talked to me a little bit about Maryland and baseball and how he figures himself is among them great stars out of Baltimore. So I know one thing. They're in there with a bad bunch that are riding high on a high note.
Schoolboy by Caleb.
The conglomerate.
And in comes Johnny Prime.
That was pretty cool action. I mean, we got some, Caleb took the start of this thing and turned it over to Johnny Prime. Things looking good so far in their camp.
And Johnny Prime not timid at all to get in there with Lawrence Knight. As Byron Saxton watches on, in comes new danger Tyson Tarver. And Tarver was looking for that punchline, that knockout punch early on Johnny Prime. And Prime with the clothesline follows up by a cover and a kick out by Tyson Tarver. Johnny Prime's arm was injured, like I mentioned before, at the hands of the conglomerate. They drove Prime into that steel ring post. and we're all over Prime. Johnny looking for revenge here in the FCW arena.
Well, I think, you know, really what he wants to do is get a victory right here. And he's got a big old guy, this big old kid right here, Caleb O'Neal's got some skills. You know, you got to stay away from Patton's right hand. He can knock you out, 9 point, whatever it is, second. I mean, he can put you on your ass. I can't say that, I know, but.
That's okay, we'll beep it.
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, we did.
Johnny Prime back in there. Wow, looking forward to seeing Goldust tonight.
Back elbow there by Tyson Tarver. Quick fireman carry takeover there by Johnny Prime. And yes, Goldust is here, and you never know what's going to happen when the bizarre Goldust is in the arena.
You know, he's my oldest, and he's one of them young men that took his, took his own path to stardom and greatness, and really thrilled when they inducted me into the Hall of Fame. That's really cool in 07. So, I mean, I'm really looking forward to seeing him back in action.
And Johnny Prime hard into the buckle. Tyson Tarver challenging Caleb O'Neal to get into the ring. And O'Neal does come in and draws the referee over and allows this, the conglomerate, to get all over Johnny Prime.
Yeah, you know, Caleb trying to do what he can, understanding not being in an opportunist, situation in tag teams all the time. He might have made some type of mistake right there because that can cost you. Puts a lot of hurt on the other guy and just ties the ref up.
And Lawrence Knight opening up on Johnny Prime. I'm sure Byron Saxton is all smiles at ringside. Knight into the cover, hooks the leg, and a kick out by Johnny Prime. At this point in the matchup, Johnny Prime is just thinking about getting over to Caleb O'Neal, getting his friend involved, and getting this match turned around. And Knight.
Got a high knee. High knee. Didn't say high knee. High knee.
Covered by Lawrence Knight and a kick out by Johnny Prime. We are just getting started here in the FCW arena. The queen of the FCW tournament continues. Will we get an exclusive from Scotty Goldman and his Hanging with Goldman segment?
Well, you know, I talked to Scotty a little bit, and he said, yeah, he's got full access. He says, I might just wander up there with y'all. I don't know what he's doing, tonight, but pretty intriguing, this Miss Girl from Mexico. I mean, just something about her. Ain't right, Jack.
Suplex and a float over there by Lawrence Knight into the cover and a kick out by Johnny Prime. The conglomerate has been working over that arm of Johnny Prime, and Lawrence Knight goes right back into it. Jim, you mentioned the girl from Mexico. I think all we really know about her is that she's from Mexico.
And she's in the tournament, and I would classify her as hot. She is hot.
Drop kick there. Johnny Prime needs to make a tag to Caleb O'Neal. Lawrence Knight misses with the clothesline. Prime off the other side. That elbow right to the head of Lawrence Knight. Prime into the cover and a kick out by Knight. Byron Saxton thought that was perhaps a little too close for comfort.
Well, here's where the shoe throwing comes in. You know what I'm saying?
Who throws a shoe?
Well.
And Caleb O'Neal has Saxton. Schoolboy
got him
Johnny Prime on the inside of the ring, and he got him.
Wow.
Well, big. Johnny Prime continues to give the conglomerate fit stream.
Big victory for him. I mean, for the team it is. They look pretty cool together, too. That's okay.
Well, Johnny Prime with Caleb O'Neal by his side are able to pick up the victory here over Lawrence Knight and Tyson Tarver. And I don't think, Dream, that things are over between Johnny Prime and the conglomerate.
No, I see big things in that one. Talk about the conglomerate. Let's talk about what we got going on tonight.
Oh, no question about it. Still to come. The Florida Heavyweight Championship is at stake. Eric Escobar takes on another one of the conglomerate members in Black Pain.
Black Pain has the size and the ability and the meanness, if you will, to take Escobar to the limit and take the Florida Heavyweight Championship back. Me knowing that title means so much, it's going to be an amazing matchup. You don't want to miss something like this.
The Florida Heavyweight Championship matchup still to come here from the FCW Arena.
WWE Royal Rumble, live 1 week from Sunday on pay-per-view.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first from Tokyo, Japan, weighing 229 pounds, Yoshikatsu.
Here we go, the action never stops from the FCW arena. Yoshitatsu, ready for singles competition, looking to make an impact here in FCW.
Introducing his opponent from Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, weighing 255 pounds, Kabu.
We see Kabu from week to week, and Josh, you know, he's a guy that's almost there. I mean, you know what I mean? He just gets so close, and he's so I think there's a lot of angry in him, you know what I mean? And I think once he can harness that, he's going to be okay. He's going to be cool. Got a great look, great athlete, unbelievable. We need to sit down with him sometime. Maybe we'll get Penguin Goldman one time to sit down and really find out what he's all about right here. This could go either way.
Yoshitatsu and Kafu set to go one-on-one. Of course, Kafu, the Brazilian beast. Yoshitatsu, another Japanese athlete looking to make an impact here in FCW. And of course, looking to make his way to World Wrestling Entertainment. That's what it's all about here in the FCW arena.
Both these guys very, very acquainted with the kicks. Spin kicks, the back kicks, and that stuff you studied, that
capoeira.
Yeah, the capoeira deal and the capoeiros and all that stuff. I mean, we're going to see a lot of it right here, I believe. I hope they don't use that, you know, sometimes don't slip over here in the corner. Like in boxing, you slip in the corner when you step on water, and I see this guy's robe still over here. Kind of worries me sometimes when I see garments laying over here and you slip on it, and, you know, it just... hopefully that don't happen. It's red. It's in the corner. I think everyone can see it. And now it's gone.
Go behind there. By Yoshitatsu. Rolls through. Here comes Kafu. Up and over goes Yoshitatsu. Throws the kick. Kafu ducks. And so does Yoshitatsu.
Oh.
Arm drag there. Followed up by a hip toss. Kafu down. And Yoshitatsu with the headlock here on Kafu.
When you say that real fast. Say it like 20 times.
Yoshitatsu.
Yeah.
It's getting easier to say.
Yes, it is. Yoshitatsu.
We'll see if Yoshitatsu can become another great Japanese superstar, following the likes of Yokozuna, the great Muda, Masahiro Chono, Jushin Thunder Liger. The list goes on and on of men that have come from the land of the rising sun and made an impact here in the States.
That Kalawea kick just got him in the back of the head right there. Kind of stung him just a little bit. Kind of stung him, man. I'm telling you, get your tickets to get in this place. This is where you need to be. Florida Championship Wrestling, FCW Arena. Come on down here, see everybody. Bright House Sports Network. Who else I'm plugging?
Plug my website, joshmatthews.com.
Well, no, I didn't, but you just did.
Kafu. His culture is that the hands are creative, the feet are destructive.
Let me, these two guys here, where do you think they came from? They came all the way across the pond, you know what I mean? A long way to get where they're at right now.
Kafu cover, hooks the leg and a kick out by Yoshitatsu. Kafu from Brazil, that's why we call him the Brazilian beast.
Well, the beast thing always give me, but the point I was making before you really interrupted me, Josh,
you were done.
Was that they've come a long way, and both a victory here would mean a lot to go towards their fortitude, if you will, to become a member of the World Wrestling Entertainment Universe.
So the road to the top passes right through Tampa, Florida, and Florida Championship Wrestling.
Exactly what I was trying to say. Couldn't have said it better myself.
And Kafu scooping a slam on Yoshitatsu. Kafu in control on a night where we will see the Florida Heavyweight Championship hang in the balance as the champion Eric Escobar defends against Byron Saxton's Black Paint, covered by Kafu.
Could I ask you something?
Yes, please.
Did you see hanging the balance again? Did you see that again?
Once a week. Once a week, I allow myself.
Did you say that?
Yeah.
I'm going to put a jar here. We put money in, like $100 bills every time you say it.
Yeah? I'm good for one, then. Strong elbow there by Cafu. Yoshitatsu needs to get something going here.
He's coming back with another forearm right there. Now the little exchange. Both guys, I think, were feeling each other out.
And now just exchanging hard forearms. Yoshitatsu ducks. Japanese strong style being shown right now by Yoshitatsu with those buzzsaw-like kicks to the chest of Cafu.
Got an arm whip here.
And Japanese whip into the corner there, followed up by the knee. And here comes Yoshitatsu. Strong kick once again. Cover hooks the inside leg and a kick out by the Brazilian beast.
Yeah, he just kicked a snot out of him. I mean, you know what I'm saying? You ever been in a fight with your little brother when you was a kid?
No.
That's what's happening right there.
And you know what it was, Dream? It was those exchanging of elbows there that really kind of ignited Yoshitatsu.
Oh, he's got him hooked up here.
An octopus-like hold here by Yoshitatsu.
Tapped him out. Tapped him out. Tapped him out.
Cafu just tapped out.
Here is your winner, Yoshitatsu.
I think we've just witnessed the first tap out in FCW TV history, courtesy of Yoshitatsu on Cafu. Great maneuver there by Yoshitatsu. We are just getting started here in the FCW arena. Don't go anywhere. Goldust is in the house.
Yeah, I'm going to tell you, I just got word Scotty Goldman's coming out here. Hanging with Scotty, going to be right here.
You want. Welcome back to Florida Championship Wrestling. I now turn the show over to the man in the middle, Scotty Goldman, for Hanging with Goldman.
Yeah, we're hanging with Goldman.
Well, we're glad to be hanging with you tonight. I'm really curious. Did you find out a lot about the girl from Mexico? I mean,
I found out a lot about all the girls. I want to hang out with everybody. I asked them all out on dates. They all rejected me, but I'm trying because we're always hanging with Goldman.
It's you.
And now, well, here she is.
Yeah, speaking of the girl from Mexico, there she is. Looks like she's a blonde, doesn't it?
Yeah, not much of a talker this one is, but the personality really comes out. Otherwise, in other ways.
The following contest is an opening round for the Queen of FCW Tournament. And it is scheduled for one fall. In the ring, the girl from Mexico.
She don't have much of an imagination on the name side right there. Could you, I mean, you were closest to us. You know, what is she, about 6 foot tall?
That's a large lady and not a bad thing, because sometimes I like these different ladies in different packages, especially me. I know Josh, too.
Oh, no doubt about it. I love him.
Introducing her opponent from Fort Lauderdale, Florida, Sailor James.
Scotty, I gotta ask you though, is the girl from Mexico as beautiful up close as she is from where we're sitting right now?
The lips were dynamite, full, and succulent. Somebody.
Succulent.
You paint quite the picture, Scotty.
Yeah, I sure do. I'm a painter and a commentator. I feel like a NASCAR driver with these things on right now.
Well, ooh. The bell's rung. We want to see what she's got, obviously.
It's a nice ring jacket.
Yeah, got a nice ring jacket. And, you know, wow. Well, here we go.
Ooh.
She looks in great shape.
Ooh.
Looks in great shape.
Don't forget, this is an opening round contest in the Queen of FCW tournament. Last week, Angela advanced by defeating Rosa Mendez, and now the girl from Mexico looks to beat Sailor James as Scotty Goldman is joining us here on commentary.
Scotty,
with a little Hanging with Goldman.
Yeah, hi. Scotty, she's a little more nimble in the role than she is talking English, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, apparently Lucha Libre, that's what she's doing, guys, and we're hanging with Goldman. It's not just a feature, it's a lifestyle.
Well.
And now the girl from Mexico
I'm
on
amazed.
The run.
I don't know what to say, I'm amazed.
Look at that.
She can move. And apparently a gymnast, too, huh?
That's kind of a Lucha Libre move in there right there. I don't know what you do from there.
That's a distraction there.
I'll tell you what, these girls are hot.
Oh, wait a second.
Whoa. Rosa. Hey, Josh, what happened there?
I don't know what Rosa Mendez, a foreign object, if you will, to the back of the head of Sailor James. And the girl from Mexico advances.
Here is your winner, the girl from Mexico.
Wow.
You think she has a shot at this or what?
I mean, she looks like a top-notch contender with her moves in the ring, but it wasn't her moves that got the win, was it?
Well, you know, I mean, wow, you've got every move you can, but bottom line is, you know, Roca was the last week when nut, you were back there, you know. And after she had lost that first round, and it looks like she's kind of involved in just messing this whole Diva thing up, man. Wow, that was amazing.
Well, we will be right back, but don't forget, next week right here in the FCW Arena, WWE superstar Kofi Kingston will be in the house.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Brooklyn, New York, weighing 225 pounds, Mike Rule.
A tremendous opportunity for Mike Rule here, Dream.
Yeah, you have an opportunity to set up against, like I said, one of the WWE superstars of all time, and an electrifying entertainment. You know, my son Goldust is going to be good. I'm going to enjoy this. This is a great entrance right here. Everybody on their feet.
Introducing his opponent from Hollywood, California, weighing 250 pounds, WWE superstar Goldust.
He is eccentric and bizarre, but he's also a former Intercontinental Champion. And he knows what it takes to get it done at the next level. He is Goldust.
Signature. What we've always known and learned about Goldust is he's tremendous in the ring. Bizarre he is, at home and away, believe me. You know what I'm talking about.
But the mind games with Goldust begin as soon as you hear that music. And now here we see Goldust ready for action with Mike Gruhl. Great to see a WWE superstar in action here, Dream.
It really is. I mean, being the opportunity to have them come in here, and next week you say we got Kofi Kingston. I mean, major, major stars in and out of FCW. That's why you need to be here in prison and get your ticket somewhere.
Clean break from Goldust. And there we see signature Goldust there.
Yeah.
And Mike Gruhl doesn't know how to take this right now.
No, Mike Gruhl's a great athlete. Mike Gruhl's one of these young men here that is really on the hunt. And I'm talking about a lot of people looking at him. He's very high-touted, if you will, if that's a word that I'm using. Like you said, it's a great opportunity for him tonight. Get locked up here against one of the all-time greats, still great, still doing it.
And, of course, every single week there are scouts from World Wrestling Entertainment here, and a tremendous opportunity
for
their superstars against Mike Gruhl, and a quick kick out there by Gruhl.
You see what Goldust did right there when he went, he went with the tackle. Usually a guy would do a tackle run on through. He's right there, boom, right down for the cover, trying to get to 1-2-3. Amazing athlete. I will say that. An amazing athlete. Not biased. I'm talking truth. Mike Gruhl needs to try to figure out what's going on here and how to handle this.
Mike Gruhl looking at Goldust. I don't think he knows.
I like Mike Gruhl now. I didn't say Mike Gruhl was bad. You know.
Goldust with that arm of Mike Gruhl. Don't forget, still to come, the FCW Heavyweight Championship on the line. Black Pain versus the champion, Eric Escobar.
I just had a heck of a thought. In Brooklyn, you're walking down the street and you see somebody like Goldust. Would that be an amazing sight?
Yeah, it would be an amazing sight.
I mean, how would you act to that? You don't see many people like that in Brooklyn.
You don't see many people like Goldust anywhere.
That's true.
And Mike Gruhl is going to think about this one here. And you can see the patience of Goldust as he's just waiting Mike Gruhl out. Never once taking his eyes off of his opponent, though.
Yeah, never gets in a hurry. A master of mind games. Gets you in a situation to beat you 1-2-3. It's a big thrill for me here, Josh. You know what I mean? I'm kind of dumbfounded here watching this thing. It's like, you know, watching your son out there as he made his trade. Well, now we're going to have a talk about it.
And Mike Gruhl there with a shot, and Goldust fires right back.
Whoa, what a right hand.
what a right hand that was.
Krull goes up and overside, Russian leg sweep on Goldust.
Change of momentum, that's what Mike Krull's trying to do right there. Got him in a situation to change it, and now pounding on him. You've got to be electrified. You gotta be able to turn on a dime, and once you get a guy down, you gotta be able to go with it.
Mike Krull in control here. What a huge, huge victory it would be for Mike Krull to defeat Goldust here in the FCW arena.
Huge victory. I mean, we would hear that around the world.
And Goldust hard into the buckle.
Yeah, when you talk about how you get...
Cover by Krull and a kick out by Goldust.
Yeah, how you get attention, that would be called, a good friend of mine said this one time, a quick ticket to the top. Quick ticket to the top. Say that fast. Quick ticket to the top.
It'd be like winning the lottery for Mike Krull if he could somehow, some way defeat Goldust here. And another kick out. And Krull just driving that knee into the back of Goldust.
You know, through the years, injuries have taken its toll on a lot of athletes, and Goldust being one of them. And I just know that, this young man's still in his 30s. So I'm talking about Goldust. And if you're going to beat him, you better bring it all. And Mike Krull seems to be bringing what he can. Got him up.
Goldust fire back. Krull able to land on top of Goldust and a kick out there. How great is it for our fans here in the FCW arena to see Goldust in this intimate setting? Tremendous opportunity each and every week to see the superstars from the WWE right here in Tampa.
That's an intimate setting. I love that. That's cool, man. Bunch of crazy dogs in here. And it's good.
And Krull, again, into the cover, fails to hook the leg, and a kick out there by Goldust.
Yeah, you cannot get a bad seat in this house. I'm telling you, and all of them are full, too. Firing back. Mike's got to keep the hunt. Keep this dog in the hunt right here. Working on that back. Pounding on the...
Another cover. Perhaps a lackadaisical cover. That's not going to get it done.
You know, Mike Krull's a second-generation guy himself. You know, I'm sure that he knows injured guys. He does his homework. So he knows there's been a bad back in the family of Goldust. You know what I mean? And he's wrenching on it right here. Really putting a test to it. Pretty good matchup here, buddy.
Obviously, plenty of tape for Mike Krull to watch on Goldust, as he's been a top WWE superstar for so long. And now the fans here in the FCW arena trying to get behind Goldust. Dream, you mentioned the back problems in the Rhodes family. You may have suffered another back injury before the show even started.
Yeah, well, who gave you that line? Who pitched that line? I kind of tripped a little bit and stumbled a little bit right here, and you want to bring that up.
No. And Mike Krull taking his eyes off of Goldust, who's firing back.
Got him up right there. Whoa. Wow. Nice clothesline. Everything is planned. I mean, it's just like boom, boom.
It's fluid. And Goldust there, that's classic Goldust. And Mike Krull on Dream Street. No pun intended.
Wow.
And
there
that,
you go,
my
buddy,
friends,
it's
is
done.
The final cut.
Yeah. All right.
Here is your winner.
Way to go.
Goldust.
So fluid is Goldust. Hits that final cut. Floats over into the cover, and Mike Krull is done. Goldust is victorious here in the FCW arena. Just a great treat for everyone to see that WWE superstar right here in Tampa, right here on South Del Mabry in the FCW arena. You never know what could happen here in the FCW arena or who will show up. Next week live, Kofi Kingston will be in Tampa on South Del Mabry at the FCW arena. Don't miss Kofi Kingston.
This next match is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing 228 pounds, Dakota Darso.
Dakota Darso making his FCW television debut, second generation athlete here looking to make an impact. That's what it's all about in the FCW arena.
Just seen them back to back. Talk about generation to generation. It's amazing what's happening in our industry. The cream is rising to the top.
Introducing his opponent from Arizona. Scotland weighing 19 stone, Drew McIntyre.
There's a reason Drew McIntyre is not happy in Dream. That's because a couple of weeks ago, Drew McIntyre was pinned in that fatal four-way FCW Heavyweight Championship match by Eric Escobar, and Drew's not happy about that at all.
No, he's not, and bottom line is, all the people that are gunning for him, you know, we don't know if Escobar even had the chance tonight, you know, against Black Pain, but I guarantee you, Drew McIntyre wants that shot. He wants that thing back. You know, he wants to get another shot at that. The Chants love Drew McIntyre. You can hear from the Chants.
Dream, Dakota has been down here in FCW for a while now, making his television debut. Tell me something about Dakota Darso.
Dakota Darso, just a young man coming out of a great stable, got great bloodlines, a young man with a really tremendous high school athlete. You know, obviously he's been around the TV and around his dad for a long time and probably working out in the backyard and, you know, just trying to learn his trade. Young man right here, still in evaluation form. You know what I'm talking about? I was going to ask you a question. If we could get Scotty Goldman maybe to sneak him and Doug, his cameraman Doug, like somewhere to where they like underneath a chair or something, see if what I hear is true, if these guys wear underwear underneath them kilts. I would love to know that.
That's what you want to find out?
Well, we need to find stuff out like that because, you know, I mean, I know that sounds stupid, but I said it.
McIntyre misses, dropkick by Dakota Darso. Darso building up some speed there and dropkick to the knee.
Back of the head.
Enziguri there by Dakota Darso using his speed to his advantage. Cover hooks the leg and a kick out by Drew McIntyre.
Drew McIntyre's a big bad dude, boy. Let me tell you, he's a stud, don't he? He's one of them guys right here. That's all right. Wow.
That's right.
Did he get unloaded on? You make a mistake, that's what happens.
Somebody might want to check on Dakota Darso. He may be out.
Yeah, he might be out.
And now Drew taking full advantage.
Yeah, he might have to stop this. He's got to step in there. This young man might be injured just a little bit right here.
Dakota Darso went for a high-risk maneuver. That's
why
Drew McIntyre was able to capitalize.
Yeah, he's barely there. He's barely there.
And Drew McIntyre now has an opportunity to take advantage of Dakota Darso. That's the Scott drop.
Somebody needs to stop this. We're going to stop it right now.
This is just a formality.
Wow. Oh, wow. I've said it again. Wow. But that was a wow.
Drew McIntyre.
Championship coming up. Match coming up.
An inauspicious debut for Dakota Darso, who took a shot. And then the Scott drop. And as Dream alluded to, coming up next, FCW title on the line, Black Pain the Challenger versus the champion, Eric Escobar. That match, our main event, is next.
Hi, I'm Charlie Daniels, and you're watching Florida Championship Wrestling, and it don't get no better than that.
Following contest scheduled for one fall is for the Florida Heavyweight Championship. Introducing first, the challenger, accompanied to the ring by Byron Saxton, weighing over 400 pounds, Black Pain.
Massive, titanic, and has his sights set on the Florida Heavyweight Championship, does Black Pain. The mood changes when Black Pain comes out here.
Yeah, it's an awesome, amazing sight. Man, great news on Kobe Kingston, too. But we got a second here watching these introductions tonight. Like you say sometimes, big fight feel.
Escobar be his last.
Well, that's kind of
that's kind of a downer there, isn't it? Just a little bit.
It could happen.
What?
Black Payne could defeat Eric Escobar and become the new Florida heavyweight champion.
Well, are we going to give Eric any chance at all in this thing?
I'm just saying it could happen.
Yeah. I mean, I'm talking about I'll take the other side. That's
well, let's talk about what happened last week.
Wow.
Black Payne left the champion lying on the mat.
Well, he sucker punched him with Byron Saxton. And, you took advantage of him. But, I'm kind of saying this thing here, this if I'm Eric Escobar, this kind of gets under my skin a little bit right here. I don't know where to go with this guy.
I'm sure Eric Escobar.
I would want to wrestle somebody like you on my first title defense. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if I'd want Black Payne.
I'm wiry.
Oh, you are wiry. I've seen you in action. You're a great athlete. Let me say that.
Undefeated on that's SmackDown.
That's why I fired Todd. What's his name? Christian. Griffin.
I don't know his name either. So here we go. Florida Heavyweight Championship at stake. Eric Escobar, the champion.
He's got a stick and move. Look at the power right there. Escobar's got it right there. Stick and move. Stick and move.
All week long, I'm sure Eric Escobar has been thinking about how to stop Black Payne.
Well, there you go.
Well, that's how you stop a big man. Take out his legs.
He is breaking him down right there.
Escobar off the ropes. And down goes the champion.
That sends the message right there to Eric Escobar. I'm not going away. I'm going to be here for the full tilt.
And Black Payne just stomping the back of the Florida heavyweight champion. Eric Escobar worked so hard to become champion. He pinned Drew McIntyre in the fatal four-way to become the champion. It's well documented that the former champion, Sheamus O'Shaughnessy, is upset. He wasn't pinned, but nonetheless, Eric Escobar is the Florida heavyweight champion.
I agree with you 100%. Everything you said come out of your mouth right there, I agree with. Oh, did you hear that shot behind the head?
I heard it.
Between the shoulder blades.
I heard it. One shot by Black Payne, and Payne is in control. Escobar into the turnbuckle. Here comes the challenger. And now Black Payne, over 400 pounds, misses with that clothesline, and Eric Escobar firing back on the challenger.
You know, Eric's had a hard time getting him off his feet right here. That ain't gonna work either.
And Black Payne with a kick to the side of the head.
How agile is this big guy? Got a cover.
Cover by Black Payne. And Dream, let me ask you, you've been involved in championship matches. How much energy and effort is Escobar using just to kick out with a man of Black Payne's size on top of him?
Well, Eric Escobar, the energy level is so high. With a guy like this, and I've been in there with guys like Abdullah the Butcher, 400-pound guys, but you got to really reach down, get yourself in a position to make some type of move. Stay away from him, get your breath, regroup, and bring it. You got to bring it.
And Black Payne just stretching out the champion here. Escobar writhing in pain, trying to figure out how to get out of the massive grasp of Black Payne.
The massive what?
Grasp. The lockdown. That's basically what Black Payne has Eric Escobar in. Covered by the challenger. Hooks the leg. Hands clasped. And the champion able to kick out.
Have we not seen Escobar, though, come back from almost total disaster before? And I that's the will of a champion. That's what makes a great champion. That's what makes you the Florida Heavyweight Champion and you on the top of the list to be moved up to World Wrestling Entertainment.
That is the ultimate goal of everyone here in Florida Championship Wrestling. And Black Payne drops the champion yet again.
Did you see that? I don't think the ref's seen that. But that's the old karate thrust. Let it cut your arm off.
And Byron Saxton with a shot there to the champion.
You know what? That Byron Saxton, that's a cheap shot. But you know what? That's what great leaders do with their men. They pick the right moments, Josh. And in that moment, they come and they do what needs to be done. Because you know what Byron Saxton sees in Black Payne? Money. That's all. Money. Control, power, and money.
Well, imagine how happy Byron Saxton would be if one of his conglomerate members became the Florida heavyweight champion. And Black Pain just dishing out more pain to the champion, Eric Escobar. And Pain just has Escobar all stretched out here.
He got him stretched. Got him hooked. There ain't no way. No way to get out of that, buddy.
Will the champion be forced to submit? Escobar firing himself up.
You gotta bring it. You gotta bring it.
Escobar with the kick there, able to break the hold by Black Pain. Who will get to their feet first? It's the champion, Escobar. Can he keep Black Pain down? Escobar off the ropes, got caught. And a 400-pound sidewalk slam by Black Pain.
Domination right here by Black Pain.
Cover. Leg is hooked, and the champion kicks out.
I just really realized what kind of problem Eric Escobar is having right here, buddy. He might have bit off more than he could chew, but he's not one to say I'm going to back down from anybody.
Escobar hard into the turnbuckle. And now... Well, now Eric Escobar's caught in this bear hug in the middle of the ring by the challenger, Black Pain.
He's ragtagging him. I mean, just... I think Byron Saxton really feels that he is so close to having a champion in the conglomerate. The champion.
The oxygen being taken away from Eric Escobar, but he's showing that he will not quit. Dream, how is Escobar going to get out of this bear hug?
It's just a wheel. I'm the Florida champion. I worked hard for this. I'm not going to let this happen to me. If it happens, it happens. But not without a fight. Not without a fight.
Escobar once again being forced to rally himself up. And now firing shots to the challenger, Black Pain. And that breaks the hold. Black Pain dazed, shot to the midsection, and here comes Black Pain. Escobar ducks off the other side, shoulder tackle, no one goes anywhere. Escobar now off the other side, clothesline, can't drop Black Pain. Black Pain has legs the size of people.
There you go.
He's down.
Black Pain's down.
Covered by the champion. Is this it? And Black Pain with a strong kick out.
Is this good stuff or what?
Great stuff here with the Florida Heavyweight Championship. Being decided by Eric Escobar and Black Pain.
No. Wow.
And Escobar attempted.
There's only one man I know can do that, and that's John Cena. Pick up a man of that size.
And it didn't work out for Escobar, and down goes the champion.
Well,
Black Pain.
Here you go,
we saw
buddy.
This last week, and Escobar moves out of the way. That's how Black Pain laid out Escobar last week.
He's got to reach down right now. I'm going to tell you, this is the reason why Eric Escobar is at the other level even right now. He needs to be there.
Champion and challenger up. Black Pain comes up empty. And here comes Escobar, catches the boot to the face.
Kind of caught it with a hand there. That's good. Didn't get him full flush. Just got a word, young Garso, back there.
Oh, wow.
Wow, just a note back there. Speaking of pain, blues, and agony. Doctors are looking young Darso Dakota. Right now he's speaking, talking, and all this stuff. So
it's great news.
It's good news.
Great news, and Eric Escobar.
What's happening here?
May need to see the doctor soon as Black Pain building momentum, and here comes Pain.
Yeah, everybody's slipping tonight. You see that foot get caught right there?
Black Pain not able to connect.
Well, here's an opening here for Escobar right here, trying to get it rolled up. The big
school
guy got power.
By the champion. Black Pain stacked
He got it.
And Escobar's
Unbelievable. Still champion.
Here is your
Eric
winner
Escobar.
And still Florida Heavyweight Champion, Eric Escobar.
If that foot doesn't slip by Black Pain, may have a new champion here in the FCW arena. But nonetheless, Eric Escobar retains his title. A tremendous main event, Dream.
I'm almost speechless. It's so exciting to be part of something so big and so unbelievable, electrifying as next week, young Kofi Kingston being here. It gets better and better and better each and every week. Good job, Eric Escobar.
For the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, I'm Josh Matthews. We will see you next week right here with Kofi Kingston in the FCW arena.
Oh. She made me wanna.
Yeah!